Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Got a couple new things for you today. First is the shirt that you just saw in the opening there. This unboxing. This has just come in, and we're going to crack this open and have a look at it. I'm pretty sure I know what this is, and I'm pretty excited to crack this open right on camera here for you. Smells like the delivery guy was a smoker, but oh well. What are you going to do? Okay, so I saw this on eBay and another decent price for this one. Don't have any of these in my set right now. So I'm pretty excited to find this one, find it for a good price, and see what we've got here. A nice little postcard from trains.com. That's pretty neat. And once again, excellent packaging from trains.com. I'm always pleased with the way they package everything in shipping. Definitely no way anything is going to get damaged from that. We have a 1688E, but a 262, which I haven't seen very often. Actually, this is the first one I've ever seen. Usually I see a 242. Apparently this is a later model, 1938 or 39, I think is what it said in the online. So, but this is looking in pretty decent shape. 3, 4. Definitely a sharp looking locomotive. It's got both of the red markers on it. That's awesome. I see the E unit lever sticking out. That's good that it's there. We have the two front wheels. We have the six drivers and we have the rear trucks. I can see that the shoe here is going to need some replacing. We got a hole in it. I know some of you guys suggest filling that with solder. But while I have some replacement shoes, I think I'll just swap it out instead of trying to fill that hole. So we've got a bit of a dent here. There's that bent corner, not a problem. And it is cracked as well, so I am not gonna try to bend that back out. I'm just gonna just live with it as it is. That's fine, that doesn't bother me at all. Couple of non-original screws in this. I see it's got a little makeshift screw in the side there. Phillips head there. The other side being a slot. I'll have to check that out and see what was what. And go through the parts bin and replace it. Not a big deal, but everything's running freely right now. So what I'll be doing is I'll just put this off to the side for the moment and come back to it, and we will do a full teardown and look this over on the inside. And actually, I did notice something pretty interesting here. So on the one side, we have the strip, and you can see the notches there where the tabs go in and hold the plate down. But on this side, there is nothing. No notches, no nothing to hold that nameplate in there. So clearly, it was only on one side. A little bit of a cleanup and this thing is going to shine nicely. Now, 3, 4. Part two of this, let's just get this one out. Yes, that is definitely a pre-war tender. A little closer look for the tender. It's even got that old style coupler on it. Looks like we're missing one of these little bits here, but that's not a problem. I have some extras of those. And this is that nice cast body whistle tender. Oh, this is going to be fantastic. I can see the wire is already kind of ratty looking there, so that's going to be a replacement right away. That's still the original paint on it. You can tell because of the way it is. A little bit scratched up, but that's not a problem at all. Yeah, just missing one of those. Not a big deal. Got quite a few of them downstairs. Pop one of those on real quick. Oh, this is fantastic. Very happy. Oh, that will fit perfectly. All right. So as I was saying, we're going to do a video of a teardown of this, have a look inside, make sure all of its wires and doodads underneath this shell are in good shape and working order before I throw this on the track. And this has, it's got its original light bulb in there too. Wow. And the same with the tender. We're going to tear this down, have a look inside, see what we got before we throw this on the track and make it whistle. I can't wait to share the next part of this video with you where we tear this down and have a look inside. But until then, thanks guys for watching. Don't forget to hit the like and subscribe. Don't forget to check out the shirts at redbubble.com. Maybe there's something there that'll work for you. Or if you're looking for a gift for a train fan, pop on over and have a look and see what's over there. All right. See you on the next one.